How's it going, everyone? Welcome back to MaZee. In this video, I'm going to show you a not so traditional way to run Android apps on your M1 Mac. It's absolutely free and it works. So let's get started. The method we are going to be looking at involves running Android apps through Android Studio. And though this is not what Android Studio was primarily built for, it works so well. So the first step is to head over to developer.android.com. I've dropped the link in the description. And while you're on this page, you will see the download button at the top. The next step is to click on it, and then you'll get this pop-up that shows you the terms and the conditions. Agree to the terms and conditions and then click on the Mac with Apple chip button to download it. And immediately, the download will start. It's about 1.1 gig, so make sure you have enough space for that. Once the download is complete, run the setup and follow the instruction steps. You can then go ahead and create a new project by clicking on this plus icon here. And since we are planning to run phone or tablet apps, ensure the phone and tablet option is selected on the left and then choose the no activity template and hit next. Now you can enter the name you like here, but since we don't intend to actually build any real app, I'll just leave everything as it is and then hit finish. This will create a new project and then we can go ahead and create our virtual Android device. To do that, click on Device Manager, which is one of these icons on the far right. And as you can see here, I have already created some virtual devices in the past, but let's create a new one together. There's this plus icon at the top of the Device Manager panel, which is for creating a new device. So click on it and select Create Virtual Device. This will open a new page for you to select a device definition. For this demonstration, I'm going to use the Pixel 7 Pro, so I'll click on it to select it and then click on Next. And here, you can choose a system image for the device. There's this ARM tab that shows you all the available images down to Lollipop. And you can get some recommendations on the recommendation tab. If you want to download any image here, you will just click on the download icon in front of the image. I've already downloaded this API 35 image, so I'll just select it and then click on Next. And on this page, you can give the device a name. In this case, I'm going to give it MaZee. If you like the startup orientation to be landscape, you can do that by selecting the landscape option under the Select Orientation section. There's also this option to turn on or off the device frame. I'll leave it on because I'd love to have the feel of what the device really looks like. And then you can click on this Show Advanced Settings button to even configure the device more. I'll leave all the options as they are and then click on Finish. This will add our new device under the Device Manager panel. And we can select the device by clicking on this Play button icon. Give it a few seconds and you'll see the virtual device booting up. Once you have the device fully running, you can click on this window icon here at the top to undock it from the Device Manager section to a window of its own. And you can enter full screen mode by clicking on this Maximize Window button. So now let me just quickly show you some options you have here at the top. Starting from the left, there is this power button. So if you want to turn off the device, you can just click on that. And there is this volume up button, which if you click, you can adjust the volume of the device. And then there's the volume down, which is essentially the opposite of the volume up. And then you have the rotate left, the rotate right, the back button. So let's say you are on the phone app and you want to go back and just click on it. We have the home button for going back to the home page. The overview button. So if you want to see all the running apps, you can click on it. And to close all the running apps, you can just slide to the right and you'll see this clear all button, which will close all open apps essentially. And then you have the screenshots and the record screen buttons. Now, if you want to see all the installed apps on the device, just place your cursor on the screen and swipe up. And to install and run a new app, click on the Play Store app. Next, you will have to sign in with your Google account, so hit the sign in button, then enter your email. Click on Next, enter your password, and then click on Next again, and then complete the two-step verification if required, and follow the on-screen instructions. You can go ahead and download any app from the App Store, but for this demonstration, I'll download Fruit Ninja. So hit the search button at the bottom right and click on the search input at the top to enter the name of the app. And then hit install. It will take a few seconds and after that, hit play. Since this game is in landscape mode, let's use the rotate left option I showed you earlier to set it to landscape mode. I'll just follow the on-screen instructions and after that, I can now play the game. So if you notice that the app is actually lagging for apps that require more resources, then you can edit the device and add more resources like storage, RAM, and all that to increase the speed and responsiveness. Like I said earlier, you can install and run any app this way. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, don't forget to smash that like button. Feel free to ask any questions in the comment section, and I'll see you in the next video.